Good afternoon and welcome to Magdalene Chapel. We're so happy that you're here to worship with us today on this 29th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our Mass intention today is for George and Margaret Schramm. Our celebrant today is Father Peter. Once again, we just wanted to remind you that if you would like to have a Mass said for anyone, living or deceased, or for a special intention, please let us know. Just email me or Father Peter or Rebecca and let us know the name and if you have a preference for a date. Thanks so much. I think that's all the announcements. Please know that we keep you all in prayer and we miss you. We look forward to the day when we can all be together again to worship. Stay healthy and stay blessed.
My dear friends, we gather together today, as always, to celebrate the Eucharist. We come in a spirit of praise and thanksgiving for all that our provident God has given us and for all that he has made us to be. We also come to be nourished once again in his word and sacrament, that renewed by his grace, we may go forth to renew our world in the light and love of Jesus Christ. We come together joyfully, as always, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, the love of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the friendship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, as we come to this table to celebrate these sacred mysteries, all of us are aware of times we have not lived and loved as Christ invites. We open our hearts and ask our God to heal us in mercy and compassion. You are the light and savior of the world. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are our reconciliation and our peace. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You call us your friends. You send us forth as your disciples. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sin, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Together let us praise our God. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, grant that we may always conform our will to yours and serve your majesty in sincerity of heart. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our first reading is from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord to his anointed Cyrus, whose right hand I grasp, subduing nations before him and making kings run in his service, opening doors before him and leaving the gates unbarred. For the sake of Jacob, my servant, of Israel, my chosen one, I have called you by your name, giving you a title, though you knew me not. I am the Lord, and there is no other. There is no God besides me. It is I who arm you, though you know me not, so that toward the rising and the setting of the sun, people may know that there is none besides me. I am the Lord. There is no other. The word of the Lord. Our second reading is from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Paul, Silvanus, and Timothy to the Church of the Thessalonians, in God the Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Grace to you and peace. We give thanks to God always for all of you, remembering you in our prayers, unceasingly calling to mind your work of faith and labor of love and endurance in hope of our Lord Jesus Christ before our God and Father, knowing, brothers and sisters loved by God, how you were chosen. For our gospel did not come to you in word alone, but also in power and in the Holy Spirit, and with much conviction. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you.
The Pharisees went off and plotted how they might entrap Jesus in speech. They sent their disciples to him with the Herodians, saying, "Teacher, we know you are a truthful man, but that you teach the way of God in accordance with the truth. And you are not concerned with anyone's opinion, for you do not regard a person's status. Tell us then, what is your opinion? Is it lawful to pay the census tax to Caesar or not?" Knowing their malice, Jesus said, "Why are you testing me, you hypocrites? Show me the coin that pays the census tax." Then they handed him the Roman coin. He said to them, "Whose image is this and whose inscription?" They replied, "Caesar's." At that he said to them, "Then repay to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and to God what belongs to God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
One of Disney's few but major flops on Broadway was the stage adaptation of the musical Tarzan. And they thought, since the animated movie was such a success, they had success with adapting Beauty and the Beast, that Tarzan would be perfect for the Broadway stage. And it really does work. And just technically, to have a cast of 36 flying around each other, because they're apes, they swing from vines, and have Tarzan come swinging down from the upper balcony to make his entrance, just the logistics of it. Even the complete shipwreck at the beginning made it worth seeing. But it opens with the shipwreck, and then everything goes quiet. And as the young boy and his family find themselves on a distant shore, the shores of Africa, surrounded by a totally different world than they were used to, the music picks up, and the first line you hear is, "Put your faith in what you most believe in. Two worlds, one family." Now they're speaking about being in a new world that has not been touched by humans, and talking about treating that land with respect and respecting what they find. But just think of that line, "Put your faith in what you most believe in. Two worlds, one family." It's exactly what the gospel is telling us today. You know, I've always said this gospel is the favorite of the Internal Revenue Service. Because basically, Jesus says, if you're going to follow me, you got to pay your taxes. And of course, we all know that there are loopholes to the tax law, and all of us have probably found them here and there. But we do pay taxes, and we try to seek the common good in this world. But we do that with the perspective of Christ and our risen life, which belongs to the kingdom of heaven. So it's not that these two worlds are separate. They may be different, but we are the bridge that brings them together. Because the way we act in this world shows how we will be in the next world. And as we are chosen by God, as we are loved by God, we are called to make that choice to be for one another and to love one another. That's our mission. And yet, look at what's happened to us today. We have allowed so many voices to tell us who we are, rather than listen to the voice of Christ. We have allowed groups to tell us that we're red or blue. We're much better when we're purple than we're the United States of America. We may be black and blue, but we're still united. But we've allowed groups to divide us. We have allowed ourselves to be divided into the haves and the have-nots. We have allowed ourselves to separate ourselves from creation, and rather than be stewards of it, we become exploiters of it. Our two worlds need to come together again as soon as possible, because we live as followers of Christ, then no child in our nation or any nation should go to bed hungry tonight. Because we live as disciples of Christ, every part of creation should be respected. Because we live as disciples of Christ, every man, every woman, regardless of race, color, or creed, is worthy of our respect, and we should celebrate their uniqueness and their dignity, no matter what their preference. All of us together make up the image of God. We are all part of that image. And how wonderful to have a provident God who made us so different and yet made us the same, with hearts of love, souls of faith, and people of hope. The other day, as I was leaving a cemetery after a blessing service, I was thinking, like, in the past few weeks, I've been through the death of three cousins, I've had five other funerals or blessing services, and you hear people are getting sick, and then you see the hatred in our world, and I looked around, and I looked at the leaves, and I thought, how can I not have hope? Look how God has painted this world in all its craziness, in what P.T. Barnum would call the colors of his life: gold, red, green, orange. God is with us, and we must be with God. And so these two worlds need to come together. Two worlds, one family. That's who we are. It's when we're at our best. You know, my cousin always teases me, because every time we see a Broadway show, he goes, "You will not get a theological lesson out of this." I said, "Watch me." So if he's watching today, I got one on you. But I also think that this gospel relates to a song from the disco era. There was a song written by the Bee Gees that was called "Too Much Heaven." And that refrain was, "No, it's bad, Sister Rita, don't complain, it's not my English, it's theirs." It says, "Nobody gets too much heaven anymore." Isn't it time we gave them some? Fight for justice, fight for equality and prejudice, protect our creation, celebrate our diversity, celebrate our humanness, celebrate each other. Chosen by Christ, disciples of Christ, two worlds, one family. Now let us joyfully profess our faith as did that first community with the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell, and on the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. With true hope and faith in our loving and provident God, we turn to him with these prayers for ourselves, our world, our church.
Please respond, provident God, hear our prayer. For the church, that we may manifest each day the work of faith, the labor of love, and the endurance of hope that is ours as God's people, let us pray to the Lord.
Provident God, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who will be voting, that the Spirit of God will help them recognize the critical issues before them and guide them in applying the gospel messages in their choices. Let us pray to the Lord.
Provident God, hear our prayer.
We pray for civic leaders in places of unrest, that God will inspire their efforts to communicate, guide them in establishing just policies in their communities, and help them recognize the giftedness and dignity of each person. Let us pray to the Lord.
Provident God, hear our prayer.
We pray for the healing of the earth, that God will inspire us to act boldly in addressing climate change and other abuses of the earth, so that those who are suffering may be relieved and that the future may hold many blessings for the human family. Let us pray to the Lord.
Provident God, hear our prayer.
Today we pray for the La Roche University community. We pray that God will guide us in being faithful citizens without compromising our discipleship and service to God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Provident God, hear our prayer.
For all those who are ill, especially those in our own La Roche University community, we especially remember all those who struggle with cancer, as well as their caregivers and those with family members who have chronic illnesses. We pray that they will know healing and peace and renewed hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Provident God, hear our prayer.
Finally, we remember all those who have died, especially those among our family and friends, that they would be brought to the fullness of eternal life in Christ. We remember especially Marianne Pavlik, who recently passed away, and George and Margaret Schramm, for whom this Mass is offered. Let us pray to the Lord.
Provident God, hear our prayer. Loving and provident God, once again we entrust our prayers to your care, confident that you will always do what is best for us, that we may always be our best for you and one another. Watch over us and guide us, keep us always in your care. Hear and answer our every prayer which we make through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that the gifts we have prepared will be a pleasing, acceptable offering to God, our loving Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and the good of all of His church.
Grant us, O provident God, we pray, a sincere respect for your gift, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be renewed by the very mysteries we serve, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our blessing and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with all the angels and saints in heaven, we too declare your glory, as with one voice and one heart we acclaim and pray.
Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts,
heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord. You are the fount of all life, all love, all holiness. Make holy, therefore, our gifts through the power of your Spirit, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly his passion and death, he took bread and, giving thanks, he broke it. He gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup filled with wine. Again, he gave you thanks. Giving the cup to the disciples, said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of a new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sin may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate this memorial of his passion, death, and resurrection, we offer you, our provident Father, the bread of life and the cup of eternal salvation, giving thanks that you have found us worthy to be in your presence, to minister to you, with you, and for you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by your Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of faith, hope, and love, together with Francis, our Pope, our Bishop David, and all the bishops, with the consecrated and religious laity, clergy, and all your people. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all those who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that one day, with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with the Apostles, Mary Magdalene, Marie de la Roche, Wilhelm Kettler, and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we too may be co-heirs of eternal life, may praise you and glorify you with Christ, our risen Lord and Savior. For it is through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, that all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
With faithful and confident hearts, Let us now pray for the coming of the kingdom in the words our Savior gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your people, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us share with one another the sacred gift of Christ's peace.
You take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Grant us peace.
This is Jesus, the light and Savior of the world. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Happy and blessed are we who share the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
As we prepare to go forth and be light and love for one another and our world, let us pray together our prayer for peace.
Lord, be with us, so that we may not look forward with fear to the changes in life. We are in very own, and we believe that you will lead us safely through all things. And when we cannot stand it, you will carry us in your arms. May we not fear what will happen tomorrow. You are our everlasting parent, who cares for us today, and we believe that you will care for us every day. Lord, assure us with suffering, or give us the unfailing strength to bear it. May we be at peace, and so put aside all anxious thoughts and imaginations. In this peace, we know that the love of God surrounds us, the light of God shines in us, the Spirit of God hovers over us, the presence of God unfolds with us, and wherever we are, God is. Through Jesus, Mary, and Joseph, family like us, we ask for all of this now and forever. Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that benefiting from our participation in heavenly things, we may be helped by what you give us in this present age and prepared for the gifts that are eternal. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May our provident God bless and keep us all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration here draws to a close. Our journey and mission continue. We go forth in peace to love and serve our God and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Have a blessed day.